Poštovani sugrađani, dobroveče. Danas smo ušli u mesec februar, utorak je i kao i prethodnih nedelja možete i večeras pogledati polučasovnu emisiju Televizije Avala. I večeras je pripremljeno nekoliko interesantnih priloga. Kao što znate, u sredu 26. januara proslavljen je Dan Australije. Ove godine jedna od svečanosti bio je tradicionalni Oz koncert na kome su ove godine učestvovale naše folklorne grupe Krajina i Sveta Trojica.
Nalazimo se ispred Entertainment centra gde se održava koncert povodom Dana Australije. Na ovom koncertu učestvuju sa svojim kulturnim baštinama Australijanci različitog nacionalnog porekla. Među njima su i dve srpske folklorne grupe. Folklorna grupa Crkve Sveta Trojica i folklorna grupa Krajina. A sada par pitanja za gospodina Jolića, čije ćerke učestvuju na današnjem koncertu. Gospodine Joliću, što mislite da je važno da srpski folklor učestvuje na ovakvim multikulturalnim manifestacijama?
Pa ja kao jedan od osnivača Srpskog društva Krajina mogu reći da sam prezadovoljan, jer smo sa ovim ispunili ona naša očekivanja i ono zašto smo mi taj folklor i osnovali. Naime, osnovno je bilo da naša djeca uče srpske narodne igre i običaje i drugo, ono još isto tako važno, da se naša djeca aktivno uključe u ovdašnji australijski život. Da oni ne budu negdje na marginama australijskog života, oni će danas ovdje učestvovati u programu otvaranja i zatvaranja zajedno sa ostalim Australcima, a ujedno će i odigrati ovdje jedno naše srpsko kolo. Tako da smo po tom pitanju izuzetno zadovoljni. I još bi jedno napomenuo, da ovdje učestvuju zajedno dva folklora, folklor Krajina i folklor iz Crkve Svete Trojice. Naša saradnja već je nekoliko godina na jednom izuzetno dobrom nivou i možda je to i prilika da se i ostali srpski klubovi ugledaju na našu saradnju, jer samo sa tako jednom dobrom saradnjom može se postići jedan dobar rezultat, a mislim da ovaj rezultat danas je jedna izuzetno velika stvar.
The 400 performers that you will see and hear this afternoon are a snapshot of the sort of people who have made this country the best place on earth. They are a remarkable group of very talented people, young and old, from very diverse backgrounds, but united in a common desire to be good citizens, making their contribution to the nation that they proudly call home.
We truly have become a great multicultural nation. And what this concert does is it celebrates the very rich tapestry that we have woven in this country. Now, through citizenship, bridges are built across individuals and communities of all types, bringing Australians together and strengthening the national identity that unites us all.
Sa mnom je koreograf obe grupe Mira Podraščanin i par naših mladih igrača. Miro, kažite gledalcima srpske televizije Avala, sa čime se naš folklor predstavlja danas?
Naša folklorna grupa predstavlja se sa igrama koje se zovu Šopske iz istočne Srbije.
Ko je organizator i da li je ovo prvi put da vi učestvujete na ovom koncertu?
A organizator OZ koncerta je vlada Australije i ovo je naš drugi put kako učestvujemo na ovom OZ koncertu.
Thank you.
26. januara ne obeležava se samo Dan Australije. U narednom intervju moći ćete čuti nešto više o tom datumu.
Today we are catching up with Clary Isaacs, who many members of the Serbian community will remember from his participation in the Concert for Peace in Serbia and many other events organized by the Serbian community. For our viewers who do not know Clary, he is a human rights campaigner of Noongar origins. Today you are participating in a protest marking Australia Day. Why is the Aboriginal community calling Australia Day Invasion Day?
Well, this is a day when white Australians celebrate the invasion of our country. It was the illegal occupation of our land, the massacre and killing of our people, the exploitation of our resources in this country as well.
What rights for Aboriginal people are you campaigning for?
Well, every Minister of Aboriginal Affairs today is a white man. This sort of thing, it wouldn't be accepted in America or in any other country in the world. Today, all the judges are ignorant white men and women. There's not one Aboriginal judge in the whole country. The Chief Justice, David Malcolm in Australia, raves on about human rights values. He's the biggest hypocrite of justice because every day the judges are doing political bashing and imprisoning Aboriginals.
In fact, you have travelled the world and met with many world leaders campaigning for human rights, not only for Aboriginal people, but for all people.
Yes, I've been to Malaysia about 6 times and met with political leaders in Malaysia. I've been to the Middle East as a guest of Colonel Gaddafi. I've been to America and I worked on the presidential campaigns of Bill Clinton. And I've been to Brazil and met with leaders there in Brazil, South America, and met with Gerry Adams when he came here to Perth. I spoke to them about human rights atrocities in Australia.
You also spoke at the Concert for Peace in Serbia, which was held at Forest Chase during the NATO bombing campaign last April. Why did you want to do this?
Well, human rights is a matter of people all over the world. It doesn't have any geographical boundaries, and everyone must participate in it to see that the atrocities are brought to an end. Australia is one of the perpetrators of crime. They're involved in the killing of civilians in Serbia, the bombings, they are part of that, a part of the whole victimisation of the civilians.
What similarities do you see between the experiences of the Aboriginal people and the situation that the Serbian people find themselves in today?
I think the most common similarity would be the dispossession of land and the forced removal of people. A lot of the Serbians now are forced to live in many other parts of the world because of military action and inhuman treatment to them.
Besides your participation at the Concert for Peace, what have been your experiences with the Serbian people?
Well, about 30 years ago, there were 3 Yugoslav boys who lost their family, or they lost their father, and their mother couldn't care for them. She was under a bit of pressure. So her children came to live with our family. They lived there for about 5 years with us. So we were very accustomed to living with these people and sharing everything with them.
The Aboriginal community has lent its support to many actions taken by the Serbian community. And I also know that many members of the Serbian community have supported actions taken by the Aboriginal community. Would it be fair to say that a strong friendship has developed between the Aboriginal and the Serbian communities?
Yes, I think it has, and it's the similarities which unite these people. And I think it's a good foundation for closer links and addressing the needs of both people that the unification will create. It's quite different in a way from many other people who have come here to Australia and just set up their house here and live here with a totally removed sense of what the problem is in Australia. The Serbian community have clearly seen the similarities here in Australia and have lent their support to our people.
Clary, the Serbian community wishes you and all Aboriginal people success in your campaigning, and we hope to see you again soon.
Thanks very much.
Sada imate priliku da čujete nešto o najnovijim planovima i događanjima u Sportsko-kulturnom klubu Srbija i u ekipi Belih Orlova.
Nalazimo se na terenu Atine, fudbalskog kluba, gde se održala prva prijateljska utakmica u ovoj sezoni. Vesko, kakvi su planovi?
Pa prvo, evo, kao što ste videli, danas smo odigrali prvu prijateljsku utakmicu posle treće nedelje priprema, teških i jakih priprema. Ovo je bila prva prijateljska utakmica, zakazali smo protiv Atine, kao što će da bude to će da bude jedan način da se pripremamo sa jačim ekipama, da vidimo koliko možemo i koliko smo spremni u datom momentu. Što se tiče daljih, takođe moj menadžer je organizovao nekoliko prijateljskih utakmica prije početka sezone. Od ponedeljka počinje, u ponedeljak imamo sjednicu sa federacijom, odlučit će se gdje se igra i kada noćna serija, tako do toga datuma, nadam se da će to da bude prva nedelja u februaru, do toga datuma organizovat ćemo još nekoliko utakmica, tako da sigurno naši gledalci će biti obaviješteni o svemu. Pripreme idu po planu, danas smo, kažem, odigrali, zadovoljan sam kako smo odigrali, sigurno je bio jak protivnik, pobjedili su nas, ali nismo očekivali neku pobjedu, ali očekivali smo samo da na nekim mjestima dokažemo neke stvari.
Čuli smo da su u Srbiji neke lepe promjene, šta možeš da nam kažeš o tome?
Je, promijenit ću jezik malo. Je, this year we got some new committee on the club, of course. I think young and good, they're looking after for good things this year. And of course we got Paul Lombardi as a manager. I think that's a great thing for the club. He's a very good man. He's been on the club last 2 years with me, and he's a very smart man. He knows this game, the player respect him, he's a businessman, and he's I think as a manager he can help us a lot this year.
Yeah, Vass has asked me this year to come down and help the club at a managerial level. I think from the most important thing, what we're going to try to do this year at the club is improve our player depth. Last year, the first half of the season was very successful, and towards the end of the season we fell away predominantly because of lack of inexperience, lack of players, and just basic inexperience. So we're looking at improving player depth, and we're in a much better position than we were last year at this time, and I think by the end of the night series competitions we should have a very formidable squad, and we should have a very good season in the first division. And we're looking to be as successful as we can at this level, and of course move forward.
Danas okrećemo još jedan list male srpske čitanke.
Ovaj kamen Binjektaš ovde služio isto onoj svrsi kao i kamen Binjektaš ispred Miloševog konaka u Topčideru u Beogradu. Dakle, na njega se knez Miloš peo kad je uzjahivao konja. I pored sve svoje tvrdoće i surovosti, Miloš je bio veoma pobožan čovjek. bio toliko pobožan čovek da je slavio i držao se svih praznika, postova i obaveza u Srpskoj pravoslavnoj crkvi. U svakom svome konaku i u Srbiji, dok nije u izbeglištvu, imao je posebnu odaju koja se zvala Soba Bogomolja, u kojoj je svakodnevno provodio dugo vremena iskreno i pobožno moleći se Bogu. Dok je boravio u Srbiji, u tim sobama Bogomoljama uvek je imao po jedan časovnik koji je odbrojavao ne samo pune sate, nego i četvrti sat. Pa su njegovi dvorjani znali da je po pravilu pun sat provodio moleći se Bogu. A kada je posle 1839. otišao u Vlašku, kažu njegovi savremenici, nikako nije mogao tako dugo vremena da provede u molitvi. I onda se ponekad vajkao svome svešteniku govoreći da eto srce mu nije na mestu jer živi u izbeglištvu u Vlaškoj i da zbog toga ni njegova duša ne može biti mirna, pa ni tako dugo ne može provoditi vreme moleći se Bogu. A onda je zaključivao, eto kako sam bio u Srbiji mirnoga srca i dobre volje, da sam mogao iskreno i čestito moleći se Bogu, a vas da sam za to i imao razloga. Tako je Miloš pomalo i priznavao za ona neverstva i zločine koje je činio tokom života, koje politički život nosi sam po sebi. Knez Miloš je uveo proslavu Svetog Save u Srbiji kao državne slave i naredio da svi stanovnici u zemlji moraju tog dana da idu u crkvu, da daruju svoje hramove i da poštuju kult Svetoga Save. I posle proslave tražio je da mu se referiše iz čitave zemlje da li je njegova naredba poštovana. I odasvud su stigle potvrdne reakcije, osim iz Beograda, gde mu je poručeno kako su svi poštovali njegovu volju i proslavili Svetoga Savu, osim Grka, trgovaca u Beogradu. Ljutit, Miloš je pozvao jednu delegaciju grčkih trgovaca iz Beograda da dođe k njemu i da ih izgrci. I ovi trgovci su došli na poklonjenje Milošu koji su to vreme privremeno nalazi u Požarku. I Miloš je odmah počeo da ih grdi i da im kaže da oni moraju da poštuju srpske praznike, a pre svega srpskoga svetitelja Svetoga Savu, da Srbi poštuju dobar broj grčkih svetaca, a da bi Grci mogli bar jednog srpskog da poštra slave. I da za kaznu sutradan svi odu u crkvu, da daruju bogatim darovima crkvu i da im se nikako ne desi da sledeće godine ponove istu grešku. Kad je prošlo neko doba i došlo da se sledeće godine ponovo proslavlja Sveti Sava, uplašeni grčki trgovci iz Beograda su pitali svoje kolege i prijatelje u Beogradu kada dolazi onaj srpski svetac Sveti Sava, da što pre, kako kažu Grci, darujemo srpske crkve, da nam onaj dusman iz Kragujevca ponovo ne naplati veliku globu.
To za večeras, nadam se da ste uživali. Ne zaboravite da se uključite na kanal 31 i narednog utorka. Do tada budite pozdravljeni od vaše večerašnje voditeljke Marine i cele ekipe televizije Avala.
Da li si spavala? Da li si sanjala? Kako se ruši Avala? Da li te nervira brat ti iz svemira, pošaljem leptira.